We're exploring the Intertropical Convergence Zone, or ITCZ, a key part of our global weather system. It might sound complex, but by the end of this video, you'll know why it brings tropical rain to places like Brazil, Nigeria, and Indonesia. The ITCZ is a place of low pressure that circles the Earth near the equator, usually between 5 degrees north and 5 degrees south, but it can move north and south within the seasons. It is where the northeast trade winds from the northern hemisphere meet the southeast trade winds from the southern hemisphere. The sun's rays are strongest near the equator. This intense heat causes air to rapidly rise, creating low pressure. As the air rises, it cools, condenses, and forms thick cumulonimbus clouds, leading to heavy convection rainfall almost daily. This is why tropical rainforests like the Amazon in Brazil, the Congo Basin in Central Africa, and the forests in Indonesia experience such wet, humid climates. On either side of the equator are the Hadley cells, huge loops of moving air. Warm air rises at the ITCZ and then travels north and south in the upper atmosphere before cooling and sinking down at around 30 degrees latitude. This creates hot deserts like the Sahara or Atacama. Beyond the Hadley cell, we have two more important circulation cells, the Ferrel cell and the polar cell. The Ferrel cell sits between 30 and 60 degrees latitude. Here, colder air from the poles meets warmer air from the tropics, creating unstable conditions and changeable weather, like we see in much of Europe, the USA, and China. This is often where many temperate climates are found. At the poles, we find the polar cells. These are smaller and driven by cold sinking air at the north and south pole. The air here is dry and stable, which is why regions like Antarctica are technically deserts, even though they are covered in ice. Together, the Hadley, Ferrel, and polar cells form the global atmospheric circulation system, a huge engine of moving air, weather, and climate patterns around the planet. The ITCZ is vital for agriculture, water supply, and even climate patterns. But if it arrives late, rains less, or shifts too far, it can cause droughts or flooding, threatening food security in developing regions. Climate change may make the ITCZ more unpredictable, which is a growing concern for the millions who rely on it. So now you know, the ITCZ is more than just an area on the map. It is a moving weather engine that brings life-bringing rain to countries near the equator and helps power the global circulation system.